Okay, so I'm here with Scott Lynch, and Scott is actually the person who puts this all together. He's also a councilman in the city of Euclid, but that's not his role here tonight. Scott, what are we doing here?
So we're very honored to be hosting again the Truth and Nonviolence Seminar here in Euclid with Swami Satyam, who's coming from Allahabad, India. And really what this event is about is understanding what's nonviolence in depth. It's a name that's often invoked, but how to live it in such a way that it has the results in the same way that Gandhi did. So when Gandhi discussed nonviolence, he always discussed it with a pairing. He very rarely said nonviolence itself. He always said truth and nonviolence. So for us, truth is that support. It's the idea of how to live in day-to-day life with a concept that everyone has, that every single person has infinite value, and every single person has infinite potential. So what that means is that people are fully capable to solve their own problems. And that's what this event is about, how to give a person the confidence and the insight and the vitality to solve their own problems. And when you have that idea, then the honor that you have for others, no matter what the background of gender or race or nationality or anything, the honor that you give them is the most sincere, because you see in that person the ability to make any change that they wish to see. But to have that, it takes a technical approach. And the technical approach that Gandhi took was Kriya Yoga meditation. And so the technical approach that we're sharing here, also with this world-renowned resource, Swami Satyam, is studying Kriya Yoga meditation. And we're doing it in depth. We've extended it for 5 days so that people can begin to understand. Because you can imagine, to become a doctor, it takes 7 years of intense study. And with this, you get the idea of how to heal yourself and much, much more. So it's not something that can be done in one day or 1 week, but gradually it comes.
And how did you become familiar with it?
Initially, I read one book called Autobiography of a Yogi. It was published first in 1946 by Paramahansa Yogananda, who taught Kriya Yoga to Mahatma Gandhi in 1935, so that he was very well known for that. And in reading that book, I came to it because I had this sense, this very American sense, that nothing's impossible. So growing up and reading about so many different saints and so many different political figures, and I never accepted the notion that people were just born a certain way, that it's just by some luck that you can achieve great things. Instead, I had the American idea that you just find the right tool and you can replicate results and you can improve results. So I searched the world for a resource such as this, and the resource which Gandhi thought gave him the strength to do his work is also the same tool which I wanted to use. That's Kriya Yoga meditation.